Oh dear. But that doesn't look right, does it? No, it doesn't. Well, it can be said that it's finally given up. Okay, it decided to pack up mid-cycle, as like a lot of washing machines do, and as like every other washing machine we've had, the poxy electronics in it have given out. Okay, the lights on the front sort of started flickering and goodness knows what else, and then it just stopped, and that was the end of that. Yeah, it's been a good one. We've never had to have it serviced or anything. Got the best part of 10 years out of it, and then it just stopped. And that's it. Okay, so that little washing machine, which has been there in the background in a few of my other videos, just minding its own business. That's it, it's out of here, it's done. Okay, time up, game over. That's the end of that. And sat on top of the washing machine, well, I wouldn't say on the top of it, it's on the side of it because it's lying on its side, and I'll show you why it's lying on its side in a minute. We got a cup of tea time. Now, I know what you're thinking right here. That washing machine's given up, so let's have it out in the back garden, motor straight on the mains, and launch something heavy straight in there. Small problem with that. Okay. That machine up in front of the camera there, when we get the new one delivered, that one is going to be taken away. Now, the thing is, if it has had something heavy launched into it, and it looks like it's sort of, been dragged around a racetrack a couple of times, they might not want to touch that with a barge pole. So that basically mean I'll be lumped with a washing machine that I can't move anywhere. Okay, now for anyone that's ever moved a washing machine, you know how particularly heavy they are. And yeah, so unfortunately, the whole thing about launching something heavy in it, that's out of the game, that's out of the question. Okay, what I am going to do though, in a minute, when I bring the camera around the other way, we'll spin that washing machine around and we'll have a look underneath it because there's obviously a few goodies in there that I want to get out of it before it goes. Okay. It was pretty obvious by the time I stripped a few bits out of it. They won't know. We'll stand it back upright, of course. And yeah, I mean, the main things I want to have out of it is the motor. Okay, we'll have a bit of fun with that. I'm not sure about popping it though. We might have a bit more fun with it other than just wiring it straight to the brushes and have it go pop. Okay, because so many other people have done that. And of course, the float switch. Okay, we'll have the top off. I think it's in the top because I can't see it from underneath. Okay, given how a float switch works, it'll obviously be at the top of the machine. Again, we'll have the top off in a minute, or whenever. And we'll have a flipping good look around in there and see if we can find that float switch and have it out of there. Okay? Right, so 3.5 minutes then, and then we'll jump straight onto the next section. Okay, so I'm going to spin the washing machine around, we'll get a different camera angle going on, and we'll have a look in there from the underside. Hold on there. Okay, then I've flipped the washing machine around, and now let's have a look in the underside. Right then, first of all, here's one of the parts I want out of it. That right there is a motor. Now, I think I've spotted the problem with the washing machine. There's a cup of tea in there. I'm going to have that. Cheers. Oh yeah, that tastes wonderful. Right, electric motor then. We're going to have that out of there. It's held in by 4 bolts, and I might have to have that back panel off. There's the back panel just there. Might have to have that back panel off in order to get that out of there. Surprisingly neat and tidy and clean condition, but then that's not the part that's gone wrong. Okay, the bit that's in that's gone wrong is a poxy electronics. And I have to be honest with you, really speaking, I think, electronics in the washing machine, nah. Okay, really speaking, the washing machine is not a place for electronics, unless that is you've got it out in your garden, and that there hole on the front of it is having electronics fed into it while it's going full bore. Okay, that's probably about the only place in a washing machine where you stuff electronics, okay, in there while it's going full bore. Right down there though, we're going to have, well, I'm going to try and have it out. Okay, it's held in by four bolts, okay. I've got the camera on the lowest setting on the tripod. I'll see if I can get a windy torch in there, hold on a moment. Windy torch. Okay, you can see one of the bolts there straight off there. Where's the other one? It's in there somewhere. There. Okay, I'll shine a windy torch in there. There you go, there's the other one. There. There's one. Just up a bit. Yeah, look, there's one. There. There's the other one there. And there'll be... Again, can't really get the camera in it. It's just behind, just sort of down the back of that terminal block there. And there'll be another one slung right underneath the motor. Pulling the drive belt, of course. All the usual suspects in there. Yeah, so I'll say in a minute. Well, it'll be in a minute from where you're sitting, but from where I'm standing, it will be a little bit more than that, probably be about 10 minutes. And we're going to have that back panel off, and we'll have a look at that electric motor from a different point of view. And then we'll see if we can try and get it out of there, okay? For this, I'm going to need some screwdrivers, pliers, some things, and some wire cutters, okay? Those wires there, they are coming out of the terminal block and going to, there's the brush, one of the brushes there. So this wire here, that goes to one of the brushes. And there'll be another one coming out of there. These little wires here, there's like a speed sensor in there which feeds back information to the electronic hocus pocus. And that, from that, the electronics will be able to tell how fast that motor's spinning. Okay, so it knows how to, you know, as and when to crank it up even more. And there we are. Okay, there's a little plug on there, just so you can... you know, if you ever need to have the motor out, you can just unplug that. Okay, we're not going to bother with that, we're just going to snip them wires off. Well, won't need to, because there's a connector thing there, so they can stay there. But that there, if I can get on it, that just unplugs, I believe, anyway. But I'm going to snip a lot of this wiring loom out, so I've got some connections on there, where I can put a bit of connector strip on. And we'll have this thing out in the back garden, we'll scream it up, okay? Probably not straight to the brushes, because, well, when you do that, the motor just goes down in an absolute flipping unholy mess, spits its brushes out everywhere, and then goes up in a ball of flames, okay? Now, you obviously do need variac to do that, because if you just wire it straight to the mains and plug it in, it's just one big short circuit, and it goes pop, and that's the end of that, okay? We won't be dealing that with it, because... I've got a thing, we're going to have some fun with that, because when I get that motor out of there, if I get it out of there successfully, that little blue label, orange label down there, that's got some technical information on it. We'll have a look at that. And yeah, so hold on to this. I will get my words out. Hold on to yourself there, and we'll spin this around, have the back off, and we'll view that motor from a different point of view. Okay then, people, just to let you know that, I've had a go at that flipping washing machine, and, well, unfortunately, I don't know whether the motor has got one-way thread bolts on it, or what the flipper deck is. I couldn't seem to remove them, and also, two of the bolts are sort of, the heads of them were recessed into... the support arms that hold it onto the main drum. Okay, so I wrangled and struggled with it, and I just couldn't get the flipping thing out. So unfortunately, disappointingly, no motor fun, unfortunately. So that's the end of that. But I did manage to get a couple of other bits. Well, I won't say a couple. One other part out of that washing machine, and it looks a little bit like this. There we go. Who recognises that? Washing machine components, okay. Yeah, it's a float switch. Okay. There's an air pipe. And if you blow in there, you can get the contacts in there to operate on and off. I've left some wiring on there so I can put connector strips on there. And we'll have a bit of fun with that later. But in this vid, in this section, had an interesting little development when we got the new washing machine and put it in and went to try and use it. It turns out that there might have been a small possibility that the washing machine, which I've just ripped parts out of and has since disposed of, might not have been faulty at all. Because, well, when we tried using the new washing machine, we experienced similar problems, okay? Looking a little bit further into it, I managed to find the problem, and it looks a bit like this. But, okay. Turns out that the reason why the old washing machine was malfunctioning is because that flipping socket had a loose connection in the back of it, and it was sparking and popping and goodness knows what else, and it was causing the washing machine to misbehave, and because the power kept dropping out, it was making the electronics go haywire. Okay, now I know in this first section I blamed the washing machine for going wrong, and it, you know, the electronics and all that lot, but well, we've had that washing machine for quite a few years. I mean, more than 5 years, so we had our money's worth out of it. It's just that, well, it never occurred to me to just to check the socket that the washing machine's plugged into to see if it's faulty or defective. It's only when we connected the new washing machine, in which you're going to see in a minute, well, we found out the new washing machine wasn't working at all. So that's when, you know, it's obvious you figure it out that the wall socket's faulty. So there it is up in front of the camera there. I've yet to test that socket up, so that can be a video for another day. But I've got a feeling that there's probably nothing wrong with that socket. It's just the wiring that went into the back of it. It was loose. And of course, sparking and popping in the back of there, it was causing the washing machine's electronics to drop out, especially when the motor was going on full spin. The inrush of the motor kicking in. The electricity couldn't make it across the connection in there, so therefore it's sparking and popping and causing the electronics to drop out. So there we go. That's wraps that little concluding video up. Found out that there was a possibility that our old washing machine wasn't faulty at all, but it's now gone, so, and I've had bits out of it, so it's not as if I can get it back. And also we've got a brand new washing machine now, which I'm going to pull the camera back and you can have a look at it, just to wrap this little section of videos up. Just move that out of the way. There we go. Wind that camera down. Okay, let's pull the camera back then and have a look at the new washing machine. There it is. Okay. So, let's get a little close up on that control panel then. There we go. So it's got all that hocus pocus going on. Okay. So there we are. That's the new washing machine. Yeah, so I don't know what model it is because it doesn't say on the front of it anywhere. It's not as if anything. Oh, hang on, there's a label there. I don't know if that means anything to anyone. If I flipping camera focus on it. That one. Does that mean anything to anyone? Hopefully it does, but that's our new washing machine anyway. Now, looking back on it, it's a bit of a shame I didn't get that old one out in the back garden and chuck a brick in it or something really heavy, because upon powering it up, I would have actually found that there was nothing wrong with it at all. But, well, part of the delivery of the new one was that when they deliver the new one, they take the old one away, and I couldn't have that risk of being lumped with a washing machine which is all smashed up that they wouldn't want to touch. Mainly for safety reasons or the fact that they couldn't recycle it anymore or anything like that. So it had to go in a condition which was, you know, it still looked in a reasonable, decent condition. So unfortunately I couldn't give it a brick in. So yeah, it had to go as it sort of came out of the location of that one that you see up in front of the camera there, okay. Yeah, bit unfortunate that, but there we are, and that's how these things go. So, in future videos, if I can get hold of it, we're going to have a little look at this, see if it's defective at all. It's a Crabtree, unswitched socket, and of course, we'll be having a little bit of fun with this device and see if I can make up a little box for it. Maybe get a little squeezy thing that you put on the end of there. We'll make a remote operation switch out of that. Okay, so let's wrap this section up then, and I shall show you cheerio with an out shot of those things on the floor. There's more videos coming up later on, people, and thanks for watching.